Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing blue and weighing in officially at 126 pounds. His professional record, an outstanding one. 34 victories, including 12 knockouts with only one defeat. Here is the fighting pride of Fort Worth, Texas, the two-time world champion, Pauly Ayala. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white, trimmed with black, and he officially weighed in also at 126 pounds. And he also has an outstanding professional record consisting of 41 victories, including 31 knockouts with only one defeat. Damas y caballeros de la Zona Norte, Tijuana, Mexico, the former two-time world champion, El Terrible Eric
Center. Okay, fellas. Trunks are high on both sides. Any punch thrown in this area is considered a clean punch. Now, gentlemen, we went over the rules in the dressing room. I want you to protect yourself at all times. Keep the fight clean at all times. What I say, you must obey. Good luck. Touch gloves. Play Olympia.
Too many big men make big money simply because they're big in this sport. These guys are starting to make the big money because they fight big.
And that's good for boxing.
$1 million featherweights. They're popping out all over. And here now are two more. Round one begins. Will Morales be in pursuit of the spectacular knockout victory that he needs to differentiate himself from Barrera and Barrera's cautious unanimous decision win over Tapia 2 weeks ago?
Well, he said he was going to be aggressive with his right hand particularly, so I'm going to see if that happens. I think he's going to resort back to what he's been doing in most of his recent fights, which is basically boxing.
Has done well against southpaws in the past, partially, of course, because the straight right hand, usually thrown as an overhand right, is a big weapon in his attack.
Yeah, but overhand right is not that effective when you fight a southpaw of the style that
Ayala fights.
He's got to shoot it straight through the middle, very straight punches, right between Ayala's gloves.
And Eric sometimes has a tendency to loop his punches.
Yes,
if he does it, it helps Ayala.
It helps Ayala. Especially right here, where it's a danger right here. Because in the past, for the most part, Morales have not fought that successfully with his back to the ropes.
Look at the supposedly smaller man leaning on Morales and pushing him into the ropes. Ayala, no doubt, was quite aware that Morales would put on a lot of weight between yesterday's weigh-in and tonight's fight. So the fact that he comes in having put on 13 pounds himself since the weigh-in suggests that maybe he did that to retaliate for what he knew would be the same thing on Morales.
Absolutely. And you know what also is, the difference between 1 pound, you can't tell. Sometimes the guy weigh in with their clothes on. Some women, they keep their shoes on even. They don't make you take your clothes off, so it's hard to really tell.
Morales weighed in for his underwear in this fight. Ayala was much more comfortable.
It's interesting for a guy that starved to make the weight to come in lighter than the other one who made the weight easy.
Sharp left hand by Pauly Ayala. He's landed a couple of power shots.
If the fight goes this way,
another straight left hand lands for Ayala. And Ayala once again pulls Morales into the ropes. Morales countering with a straight right hand that landed flush on Ayala's chin.
I think you heard it.
A body punch knocks Ayala back two steps. Crowd chanting, Pauly, Pauly, Pauly. And Morales' fans don't like that.
I think the danger of punching both of these guys, Arsenal, may be the hooks, meaning Paulie Ayala's right hook and also the left hook of Morales.
Morales landing the crisper looking punches.
That's the way to go, baby. That's the way to go.
There you go.
Good round.
Keep the pressure on him. When you're getting close to him, son, we need to work on the uppercuts and the body, okay? This guy is so slow from all that weight he lost, he can't even... I can see the shots as old as I am, son. This guy is nothing, okay? Now, you've got an idea of what he can do, which is nothing. How you feel? Okay, look, remember everything.
When we go to Morales' corner where they speak Spanish, our interpreter is Ray Torres.
Well, yeah, when he comes at you, just move to the side. Lateral movement.
County box numbers in round one. Eric Morales, 18 out of 53. Paulie Ayala, 10 out of 56. Morales landing 8 of 34 jabs. Ayala, only one of his 18 jabs. Morales with the longer arms and the range. You expect him to win the jabbing contest.
And he's fighting very good. When he jabs, as Ayala is approaching him, he's jabbing and not just standing. When he's jabbing and backing away a lot at the same time. Keeping that distance.
More or less dispensing with the jab, stepping inside and firing power shots with both the right and the left hand.
Well, Ayala's going to try to crowd him into the ropes. And then one of the other intangible factors, which may be a big factor, that I've noticed in recent fights, Morales has been getting swollen up and busted up in nearly every one of his fights, which sometimes can indicate that his skin and tissues are beginning to give a lot.
Against a lesser fighter, Korean Injun Chi, Morales' left eye swelled completely shut.
Yes, he's been in most of his recent, even with Barrera in the second fight also. So that could be a factor too going down the line.
In fact, the degree to which his face was marked up compared to that of Barrera may have helped judges to give Barrera the second fight against
it
Morales.
Could have been a factor. In the first fight, Barrera had a cut under his left eye.
Working behind the jabs for the first minute of round number two. Trying to keep Ayala at range. Good sharp punches by Morales there, and the left hook landed flush.
Yep.
Another left hook for Morales. He's improved that punch in the last six or seven fights.
Ayala is doing just what he should do. Keeping Morales near the ropes, at his back near the ropes, where he's not that effective.
But when they get to the center of the ring, Eric starts to deliver again with both hands. Uppercut
right
for Morales.
Great uppercut. As long as he can keep the fight at a distance where he can time, Ayala will do very good, but I don't know if he can hold him off it. After a certain while, I think that Ayala's going to start penetrating a lot closer than he wants him to.
Ayala was open again for Morales' left hook. Eric missed with the punch. Took to the body, lands for Morales. Good right hands for Morales.
Is usually very good.
Good counter left hook for Morales.
If he keeps the fight at this distance, he can be very effective.
He looks sharp. He's landing effectively with both hands. Eric Morales has it exactly the way he wants it in the last 2 minutes of round number two. Hard right hand by Morales. Ayala shows his chin, not bad.
No, he's got a good chin, but Morales is still a much stiffer puncher.
If they stay near the center of the ring, this could be a big night for Eric Morales.
Morales can win the fight if he keeps him at the center of the ring.
Everything was beautiful. That was a beautiful round. That's it. Keep him in the distance, and he takes all the feints. So you feint him and hit him. You're working beautifully. Beautifully. Don't lower your left hand too much. And you're hitting him real good.
Then you can go to the hit. Okay, but keep that double jab, okay? As long as you keep the double jab working, he won't be able to throw nothing because he's going to be watching you, okay? Then the next time we're going to change it to the one.
Ayala is a fighter who makes very good modifications in the ring. He's very intelligent. But here we see that it's Morales who has figured out Ayala, and that uppercut with the right hand was a key factor there, because his overhand right hand has not been effective.
But well, the great news for Morales, it seems to me, Emmanuel, out of the first two rounds, is that he can be effective leading or he can be effective countering.
Yeah, he's fighting. Morales right now is fighting the perfect fight. He's got his respect, and he's keeping the fight at a distance where he can be effective, and Paulie is not effective. And if he can maintain this, he'll win the fight.
So what must Paulie do to change it back?
Paulie's going to have to take a risk to some degree of possibly getting hit and close the gap and keep him in close where he can punch with short punches like that.
Busy. Ayala to the body. And obviously, Paulie Ayala aware of the need to throw more punches.
Yes, particularly when he feels the kind of punches that he's blocking on the ground, but he's got to be defensive also.
There's a good right hand by Ayala. Dropped his left.
But Morales landed a beautiful right hand right between the center, which is the perfect right hand for a southpaw. Just prior to that.
Look at Morales driving Ayala back with the right hand.
Execution for the fighting the southpaw to lean in close and then shoot your right hand right between the center.
Good uppercut for Morales. Stunned Ayala.
Good uppercut.
And Morales following up with a left hook. Ayala got in a little counter right, but the difference in power is showing up as we expected it would early on.
Ayala is shooting 22 caliber bullets. Morales is shooting 38s.
And may have a 9mm in his pocket somewhere. Another good uppercut.
Good uppercut. Morales is going strictly for a knockout. He has no intentions of going to the limit in this fight and trying to win a decision.
If he can get Ayala to keep eating that uppercut, he may get his knockout.
But you know, if he survives all of this, Ayala's going to be very tough to deal with going down the stretch. Especially in view of the fact that Morales may start swelling up and busting up.
35 fights, Paulie Ayala has never been knocked out. Has been down. For this round, it's been clear Ayala wanted Morales to lead and wanted to try to counter in bunches against him. But Morales continues to be too effective. When you lead and land, it's hard on the counter punches.
Yes, it is.
Letty Ayala, wife Bob, with a straight face so far. No great look of concern. Get him, baby.
I'm quite sure now that Paulie has a lot of respect.
You gotta be first, okay? That's what we're talking about.
The punching power,
Morales. You have to be first, okay? Danny, give me a little bottle of alcohol.
Very important with the left hand to throw combination, and especially the uppercut.
Paulie Ayala doesn't know where that right hand is coming from. Those uppercuts have been the significant blows in this fight.
Round three, a spectacular display of power punching accuracy by Morales. By CompuBox numbers, he landed 22 of 33 power shots in the round, 67%. You saw him precisely targeting the uppercut on at least two occasions. Harold, how do you have it so far?
Okay, Jim, 30 to 27, three rounds to nothing. Eric El Terrible Morales. Jim, I gotta tell you, the first two rounds, Paulie Ayala did what Paulie Ayala does. Straightforward, Eric Morales timed him beautifully with those right uppercuts, just like Larry called it. In the third round, Paulie Ayala started a circle to the right. Eric still timed him with right hands.
And Ayala's left uppercut landed there, his best punch of the fight so far.
Yeah.
looks like Paulie's ready to take some risks.
Paulie's taking a risk that he has to take in order to win this fight. He cannot win the fight by playing safe and staying back.
Seemingly aware that he's lost the first three rounds, a different Paulie Ayala comes into the ring for round four. But his eyes are starting to swell as Morales continues to target him from range. Particularly the left eye of Ayala is swelling in the face of Morales' right hand.
Yes, it is.
Another uppercut lands for Eric. Ayala gets his own left in. Aggression in this round has been stalled. He continues to drive inside and take risks, but Morales continues to punish him in return just like that.
And everything that Morales is throwing is with knockout in it. Even the jabs he's shooting with total knockout power.
There was a huge rush of judgment in the past few days here that maybe this wouldn't be another portrayal of the conventional wisdom that dominated Barrera Tapia. Bigger man, bigger punch wins. So far, though, it's been largely that. As they trade again to end the fourth round, and again, Morales has the best of it.
Give me another Barrera.
Morales, number one.
You relaxed a little bit too much right there. Don't relax like that. Don't go to the end of the round, but he's trying to take advantage of that, okay? How you feel? You gotta do what you're doing, son, okay? Gotta be working that jab, okay? But don't stop.
Don't go to your right. You gotta keep using that jab. That right hand.
Ayala's desperation is met full on by Morales.
Emmanuel Stewart, by CompuBox numbers in that last round, Paulie Ayala threw 103 punches. Eric Morales is countering him beautifully and punishing him. Must Ayala be more selective?
I think Ayala has just got to be busy and put more pressure and take more risks. But I'm really impressed with Morales' defense during the fight. He's doing a very good job, for the most part, of being very good at avoiding most of the punches that's coming from Paulie also, in addition to landing a lot of power punches.
You heard Henry Mendez telling Paulie Ayala he had to work his jab. Ayala doesn't look like he has a lot of confidence that the jab is going to get anything done. Jab, and he lands him. But now Morales whacks him with a right hand. More good defensive work there by Morales.
Very good defensive movement, and he's steadily moving in a circle, and oftentimes he'll punch and land a punch and then move his body in the opposite direction where the guy won't be able to get hook close to him also at the same time. Maintaining the distance.
He's These are five of the best and most skillful rounds Eric Morales has put together since his first fight with Marco Antonio Barrera in February of 2000.
Because a lot of time he just resorts to boxing, but he's boxing and punching. He's mixing up everything tonight.
A frustrated Ayala beginning to widen his punches a little bit. Kind of slapped at Barrera with the right hand, or at Morales with the right hand, I should say. And Morales coming right back down the middle with the straight right.
The biggest difference has been that punching power of Morales at this stage.
Driving Ayala back with both hands, and the left eye of Ayala continues to swell under the pressure of Morales' right.
Well, Morales was the one who said that you can put on weight, but until you face a real featherweight, you don't know what it's like. And Ayala seems to be finding out right here.
And also, Morales is a very big puncher in addition to being a big featherweight.
What a brilliant exhibition of defense and counterpunching you just saw from Eric Morales. Ayala landed nothing in that full long exchange.
Even if he had landed, he didn't have the power, but he didn't even land.
There he lands a right hand, but after taking a hard left from Morales. Hey! Eric Morales has been brilliant through the first five.
Let me get some water here.
Watch your hands when you're inside, okay? Keep them up.
Ni bien te pones así, Eric, ni bien te se quedan los guantes, Olivarito. Ni bien te pones así, lo levantas acá y acá comienzas con las manoplas.
Throw those uppercuts. Yeah, yeah, but a little bit of distance. Don't get too close to him so you can hit him right in the middle.
How you feel?
Good.
Okay. This is yours, man.
You're in top condition, baby.
Okay. You know you can do it, man. Okay? Keep backing him up, the double jab. Don't throw me nothing under two, sir.
Be strong on those two, sir.
Let's go, go.
Morales inside, slips a punch, comes right back with a left uppercut on that occasion.
CombiBox numbers in five, and after throwing 103 punches in the fourth, Ayala took my advice and threw only 70 in the fifth. But he landed only 15 of them as opposed to 31 of 73 for Eric Morales, who continues to dominate the bout with beautiful boxing and controlled aggression. Ayala's going to try to make it a war and rough him up. That's all he can do at this point, Emmanuel.
You're not going to get away easy fighting Pauly Ayala. He's going to bring it to him now.
Right hand and the uppercut. Ayala walking through both of them, but again, his face is taking the punishment. And Morales, who's been marked so much in so many of his recent fights, has a clear face.
Yes.
Although he just took a big left hand.
Good. Tremendous straight left hand. But a left hand from Pauly Ayala is not like a straight right hand from Eric Morales.
First minute of the sixth is about as well as Ayala has done in the fight so far.
Yeah. Now he's fighting like the fighter that has made him so popular here with the Nevada people, in particular the judges. You can't count Pauly out.
Again, Morales using his head brilliantly, dodging punches, coming back with the right hand to back Ayala out.
Watch your heads, Cabeza, watch your heads!
Ayala's corner keeps urging them to use his feet more, Emmanuel. I don't think they feel like he's creating enough angles to keep Morales from being able to hit him.
No, he can't. And he's never been a fighter to use his feet a lot, so he's not going to start that now.
Morales thinking knockout, Ayala getting hit. Oh, that's a big right hand. That stunned Pauly Ayala. He's got a great chin, but he's taking a lot of big shots.
Morales has absolutely no respect for Ayala's punch.
And why should he? Doesn't look like Ayala can hurt him.
Don't count Paulie Ayala out. Until he's knocked out, he's always going to be a dangerous guy. Not from punching power, but just the spirit that he fights with.
Finding out what other outstanding smaller weight fighters have found. Ruben Olivares, great bantamweight, losing to Alexis Arguello, the featherweight. Wilfredo Gomez losing to Salvador Sanchez. And of course, a couple weeks ago, Johnny Tapia losing to Barrera. Good little men beaten by talented bigger men.
Take a deep breath. Eric, that right hand to the body, especially to the ribs.
After taking a couple of clean blows, Morales decides to stand and punch with Ayala because Ayala cannot punch with him.
The result being that in round six, Morales landed 29 of 49 power shots, a 59% exhibition of power punching accuracy. He's been great. Harold, how do you have it through six?
Okay, Jim. Not a terribly hard fight to score. Six rounds to nothing, 60 to 54. Eric El Terrible Morales. Paulie Ayala just can't get out of the way of that right hand. Jim, Eric, you know, one of the 4 points we scored rounds on is defense. Look at the great defense by Eric Morales. He's constantly getting under that right hook of Paulie Ayala. Stop, stop, step back, fellas.
Moment of excitement for the Ayala crowd as Morales simply took a knee. Paulie Ayala's left eye continues to swell and doesn't look all that good halfway through the fight. There's the reason why. Morales still ripping him with right hands. Look at the heart and the effort for Ayala, who just won't take yes for an answer.
Nope. But right now, Morales is fighting the perfect fight. Keeping him at that zone where he's more effective at it can get the maximum punching power.
And defending himself better, I think, than I've ever seen him do.
Doing a great job of defense. Even when he bends in like this, he's usually covering up very good and protecting himself very good.
Two more straight right hands, and you wonder, I mean, Paulie Ayala, he's a guy who's going to want to make it to the finish line, but how much punishment can he take? Quite outspoken in saying, I don't think Eric's all that hard a puncher.
Well, I'm quite sure he's changed his mind by now.
Finally, Ayala catches Morales on a left hand inside. A little blood from Morales' nose as Ayala keeps whacking him. Many, many more punches from Ayala, but Morales able to drive him back with a right. Another great job of ducking the right hook by Morales.
They're holding, they're holding.
Oh, again, two more right hands tattooing the left eye of Ayalas. And I wonder if Paulie's going to be able to see. If he goes the distance here, this is rough. Blood out of the mouth of Ayala.
Yeah.
The left eye is closing up.
The left eye is going to be a real serious factor, especially when he's being outgunned in every area already.
Okay, baby.
And then to be fighting with only vision in one eye.
I'm going to do the same thing, but I want more movement. Okay? I need for you to move a little bit more, okay? A little bit more, move. Don't stay in front of me, okay? I want some more movement. Continue doing what you're doing, but you gotta do it with giving you side angles, okay? You can't stay in front of me, okay?
Don't stay in front, partner.
That's it. You keep working the same way you've been doing and throw that right hand. Yeah. That's been very successful.
Morales seems to be zoned in on the target. Ayala, as he tries to step it up, is simply met and discouraged every time.
In the seventh round, by CompuBox numbers, Morales landed 36 out of 60 power shots. That's 60%. And logic tells you, as Ayala's left eye closes and he's less and less able to see Morales' right hand, that percentage could go up. Trying to encourage Ayala and keep him in the fight. And you certainly can't deny his spirit and his heart. But it may only conspire to get him a bad beating tonight.
Yeah, everything right now is hurting him.
Mismatch or one of the better performances of Eric Morales' career. Take your pick.
I think it's a good performance on Eric Morales. He hasn't had this in a long time. Even in the last fight, when the majority of the people, including me, thought that he had won a decision over Barrera, but it was still not an impressive fight.
It was more about the tactical decision Barrera made to fight the first five rounds the way he did, and the curious outgrowth of that.
There is some blood coming from perhaps the nose.
See the professionalism of Morales as he begins to go to the body to try to set up what he surely thinks is the inevitable finish. Eric's a good body puncher. Ayala manages to snap a little right inside.
A kind of fast break offense. Just let everything go.
But still so conscious of Morales' offense, it's hard for him to do it. You know, when a guy's painting you with power punches, you start to go for feints more than you'd like. And Ayala is going for all of Morales' feints now.
Yeah, he says there's no way to try to control Morales. He can't even figure out what he's going to do.
Oh, that's a great show by Paulie Ayala. Beaten in the fight, but unwilling to give up. Eighth round, a relatively cautious one until the last 30 seconds when Paulie Ayala tried to steal the round and Eric Morales said, hell no. Punches landed round by round. CompuBox numbers demonstrating the huge advantage for Eric Morales. The eighth round was a wipeout. At what point?
Don't go back straight back.
I mean, admittedly, he's.
Don't let this guy. When you're going back, remember the angles that you use, the side steps, okay? That's what you gotta do, okay?
He's a never give up warrior, and they're a never give up corner. But at what point, Emmanuel, do you say the fighter doesn't deserve more punishment like this?
And it's strange because every time you think he's, you know, about to go, he comes right back with a flurry of punches.
There's Letty Ayala still putting on the brave face.
Let's go, Polly.
Whitewash so far on Harold Letterman's scorecard.
Morales is not only bigger, but he's better.
Yes.
There's a big left hand for Ayala, and Morales kind of fakes the damage to let Ayala know that he didn't hurt him, but that was the best punch of the fight for Paul.
Punching power is a big, big factor in this fight, and all of that goes to Morales.
Again.
Yeah.
And his left eye is about completely shut now.
At this stage, Morales is just trying to line him up to land one good clean shot to land on a good dramatic knockout.
Ayala lands another good left and a right. Again, indomitable heart and spirit. Incidentally, there hasn't been a real clinch in the fight. There hasn't been a low blow warning. There hasn't been a minute of anything but action.
Just a good solid fight. And after each one of the exchanges, you know, Pollock usually comes back at the tail end. But unlike what it used to happen in the past, Morales is fighting a beautiful technical fight.
Upper
body movement, everything.
Blocking punches to the rib cage with his elbows, ducking the right hook upstairs. I mean, everything.
Yeah, great upper body movement, not the stiff body that he used to use all the time in fights. People would just go straight back in the ropes and be straight up.
Double left hook by Morales, crushing. Will visit Ayala's corner to take a look at his left eye.
Well, it's a good round, baby. You came out stronger like that. That's
Doc
good.
Take a look.
Oh, he's all right. He's all right.
Tell me it's now.
Can you see Paulie?
Oh, yeah, he's okay. Yeah, he's all right. Yeah, he's
no, right. I look like it.
Good sense.
Now, there's a comment.
Great sense of humor. In the middle of a war.
What's the matter?
Can
what's
you
the
see Paulie? Do I look like it?
What's worse than hitting the guy with your best shot? And he just stands there and looks at you.
Well, you heard Henry Mendez, Paulie Ayala's trainer, say that was a great round. Did he actually win a round, Harold?
I don't think so. 90-81, 9-0. Eric El Terrible Morales. Jim, I got to tell you something. Paulie Ayala, I don't know if he tips off when he's going to throw that right hook or not, but every time he does, Eric Morales just gets under it. It's just amazing. He's been great on defense all night, as well as tremendous on offense with that left jab and the great straight right hands. This is a shutout for Eric Morales, undoubtedly.
Well, I'm a kind soul. I gave the round to Ayala for his effort.
I agree, you're a kind soul. Emmanuel Stewart in the corner between rounds. Eric Morales told his people that he has hurt his left hand. Does that bring an end to the knockout chances?
No, he's still punching with it. Even when they get hurt, if the full impact doesn't happen until usually later on the next day. While the blood is still flowing and the muscles are still warm, he'll still keep punching.
See, no shortage of guys winning fights with broken hands. And certainly Morales is the kind of warrior who could be expected to fight right through any injury. Well, he's not bashful at all with that left
hand. No, he's still banging with the left hand. And actually, at this stage, Paul is doing just a, he's giving about as much as he's been catching. It's just that he doesn't have the punching power.
If Morales wanted to baby or protect his left hand, the punch he might not be throwing is the left hook to the body, because if you catch a guy right on the elbow,
yes, and
it hurts.
And it hurts.
But he's throwing it. First time all night, though, Emmanuel, it looks as though Eric Morales might be content to just pound out a decision and walk away with his win.
And at this point, actually, this round, they have given to Paulie Ayala, believe it or not.
Morales has been slower paced in this round.
Yes. But he's fought a good fight, though. He's kept the fight at the distance for the most part, but he's very effective.
Ayala just keeps coming. They're through 10. Two rounds to go.
You might have two exciting final rounds.
There's two rounds left, Paulie.
These two rounds, son, we got to have the two rounds to make it to where the judges can't take this away from us, son. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay, we got to do wait. And don't move straight back on this guy, okay? This is the championship.
Come on. You got to win this big round. You let him off the hook the last time. Don't give him a chance now. He's getting big now because you're letting him grow. Come on, you're winning real good.
The hook to the head and throw it real sharp, okay? You're looking good, baby. You're looking real good.
It's two rounds, Paulie. Two rounds.
Round 11 begins. Big round for the bettors because the over-under was 10.5. In addition to all his domination in other categories, Morales has outlanded Ayala 99-17 in jabs. And normally for a conventional fighter against the southpaw, the jab isn't all that big a weapon. His corner urgently asking him to come out and produce another big round here. Well, here's the range at which Ayala wanted the fight.
Yes. But you know, for the most part, Morales has been fighting, but he's never been too much straight up in a rope. He's boxing him at a distance, or he's been bending down like that, but he's doing it very effectively when he gets in close. But he has refused to get caught with his back straight up against the ropes.
Concentrating to the body in this round, as does Ayala.
I see Julio Cesar Chavez, the legendary great Mexican fighter straight across from us. Urging Morales on. Yes, he's urging Morales on. He wants to see the knockout.
Been a knockout fighter at this weight. And he's landed some hard, clean punches on Ayala.
Tremendous punches.
And put some dents in him, but not really seriously hurt him.
Yeah,
professors accept that virtually all of the solid work by both fighters was done to the body.
Last round, baby. That's what we've been looking for. You got a punch, okay? You got a punch. Look, you got to throw more than one punch, Paulie. This is your last round, baby. 3 minutes, man.
And when you come out, I want you to touch gloves. Last and final round.
Last round. You're doing real good. Just stay back a little bit.
I want you to touch gloves. Last and final round.
Último round.
Last round. This is the last round, son.
I don't know.
Let me be honest.
I don't know that you are, Paulie. It's close, but I want this last round and you can win the title, okay? Yeah. Okay? Come on,
it's
baby.
It's close, fight, Paulie.
It's close. It's all
left. Let's go, guys.
Magua, okay?
Emmanuel, why didn't Ayala's corner tell him he needs a knockout to win?
I don't know. I think that's one of the biggest mistakes it is. Tell the fighter the truth. And you can tell that Paulie feels he's losing it. That's why he's asking, tell me the truth.
Could they really believe the fight is close? I don't think he believes that.
You know, I say sometimes the fighters can't tell. I think in this case, sure, maybe the corner can't tell.
How long do you have it? How can you? 10-1, 109, 100, Eric Morales. I mean, the only round I see poorly winning is round 10 when Eric didn't do much. Other than that, too many right hands by Eric Morales. Looks like Morales wants a knockout again.
Yeah, Julio Cesar was between rounds over in Eric's corner. Push it and please get a knockout.
Well, this is why Morales is such a thoroughbred. He has the fight won, he surely knows it. But he's not going to rest on it. He's going to fight, fight, fight until they tell him he can't fight anymore.
Well, the story's been told many times. Born above a boxing gym in Tijuana, virtually raised in the gym, son of a fighter, born to fight, loves to fight, will be a fighter as long as he lives.
Yes, and he's in with another fighter.
You know, some
doesn't have the tools.
Yeah, some speculation going into this fight that because of the weight problems that Morales traditionally has, because of the hard fights he's been, that at 26 he was starting to see middle age.
And that was justifiable because his recent fights until this fight here, he has not looked that good.
He didn't look that bad against Pereira.
No, I thought he won the fight.
Okay.
But it wasn't one of those real strong performances.
I think this is clearly his best performance since February 19, 2000, the night of the first Pereira fight.
Well, that's because of the opposition and how Ayala fights him. But give Ayala credit, outgunned, still walking into the fire.
Fabulous. He's a great guy and a great fighter, and you have to love the way he's gone about this. But he's getting whipped by Eric Morales.
But he's still fighting back, and it's really hard to hit him with two or three clean consecutive punches. You get one, and then he goes to bobbing and weaving, and it's hard to get three or four. So I think that just...
whether he should stop it.
Yeah, he's on the verge of stopping the fight. I think he wants to get Paulie to at least
absolutely
finish him, at least finish it up on his feet.
He's earned it.
And he's still fighting back.
What a tremendous shot.
And that's why the featherweights are earning the big bucks.
Brilliant, and in our view, dominant performance by Eric Morales against a brave and absolutely unstoppable warrior opponent in Paulie Ayala, who just kept coming and trying, but paid a heavy price in terms of punishment for it. In the 12th round, Eric Morales threw, are you ready, 141 punches, landing 76 of them. 74 of 135 power shots. I got a feeling Ayala is going to be eating through a straw for a couple of days here.
All you do is get 100%, you know?
If he can find his food through two small eyes.
When a man lands that many punches,
I don't want to be on the other end of it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Thrilling performance by Morales, who looked so gaunt, so troubled, so tortured by weight loss yesterday, and came back as an entirely different person tonight. 422 punches landed in the fight by Morales by CompuBox numbers. That's 170 more punches than anybody has ever landed against Pauly Ayala in a prize fight. 170 more blows than he's ever been hit with before. Let's go to Michael Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the Mandalay Bay of Las Vegas, before we go to the scorecards, a round of applause for these two 126-pound warriors. The scoring is as follows. Bert Clements has it 117 to 111. John Keane scores it 117 to 111. And Anek Hong Tong Kam scores it 116 to 112. All for the winner. Now the champion once again, El Terrible Eric Morales.
Final CompuBox numbers. Once again, just to emphasize the point, Johnny Tapia landed 252 punches by CompuBox numbers against Pauly Ayala in their first fight. Tonight, Morales bests that number by 170 blows, landing 422 out of 961. So he landed